Welcome to myprojectbazaar.com. Our project title is Adaptive and Fault-tolerant Data Processing in Healthcare IoT based on Fog Computing. Now we are going to see the abstract of this project. The main objective of this project is to securely maintaining the patient health records. There could be lots of problems that arises during the data maintenance and transmission, especially in the time of data conversion into the cipher. For the security purpose, we are going to convert the plain text into cipher text. For increasing the security level, the data is going to be transformed through the secure socket layer. Fog computing is proposed. Cloud computing plays an important role in on-demand data processing. The following layers are used in the process of healthcare record maintenance. Fog computing. This layer is responsible for processing the data because the data that have been collected from various sources have to be processed before storing. It reduces the amount of time that is needed for processing, analysis and storage. It improves the efficiency. In our cloud computing is the layer responsible for storing the encrypted data. Health provider. In the health service provider layer, a provider gets a patient information in a combined form and is a meaningful way, which was sent in a form of cipher shares through the fog computing layer. A provider should have access to the patient privacy data to monitor health performance. Now we are going to see the flow of the project. In this, there is a three main thing. One is data owner, data user and cloud. Here, data owner can log in into the process and check the role of access and collect the data. And if they collect the data, then they get a key using Diffie-Hellman algorithm. Then they encrypt the data through AES algorithm. So in the fog computing gateway, they process the data and share to the cloud. So he store the data to the cloud before they send request to the cloud, send upload request to the cloud. So the cloud will provide a permission to upload. Then data user can log in into the process and send request for accessing the file to the cloud. Then cloud check the validation of the user and send the key, secret verification key to the user. Then user can use that key to decrypt the data and download it. Now we are going to see the running process of the project. So here, first we have to run index.java, right click and run file. This is our main page. Click start. So in this, first we have to process the data owner. So now login. So now select the record. This health record. Health record is loaded. Here the number of record is 1000. Click next. Then view records. Patient name, patient ID, address, age, reason of visiting, name of disease and the final report. The treatment is going or cured. Then click next. Here we get the encryption key. This is the encryption key and encrypt the data. So this is the encryption file, then click next. Then send request to the cloud. Send upload request to the cloud. persistent request status in progress. So now we are going to run a cloud. So right click on it and run. So cloud 123. Now click view upload request. Data on upload request is healthcare card. So grant permission. Then going to the request page and view request status permission granted. Then upload patient record. So upload successfully. Then come here and view this. This is the original record and this is the encrypted record. So once again go to user page. Now register the user. Number should be intern. Password is in 6 characters. Now get a secret key. Copy this key and register successfully. Search any one of the patient. If you just any means, so here we show the search result form. So then click next to and send request. So now go to the cloud on view download request ROM, verify the user, grant permission. Then view request status. And granted, so receive a key, then click next, get key, undecrypt a patient record here. This is the patient, this is the decrypted patient details. See here, name is Guinea. So treatment is going, then click download. It shows in notepad. Thank you for watching this video.